Can you give us a brief background of yourself? Me, actually, you can visit yung aking blog at fitzvillafuerte.com. Meron about me page doon. You can see it at the sidebar. And you will read about, you will read there yung a little bit of my life story. But basically, I'm an engineer by education. So I'm a civil engineer. And then, of course, from working as an engineer, I shifted from the corporate world towards entrepreneurship, actually freelancing and entrepreneurship. So I resigned from my day job back in 2004. I pursued freelancing, so I became a software programmer and a freelancer until I discovered entrepreneurship. So I put up my first business during that time, and then nagustuhan ko kong magnegosyo. That's why I pursued entrepreneurship. I put up several businesses, and a lot of my friends were asking me, "Uy, paano ba yung ginawa mo?" Kasi gusto rin daw nilang quit ng kanilang day job sa corporate world tapos maging negosyante. So, instead of answering them one by one, I put up my blog, yung Ready to Be Rich, which is basically where I share my stories. And when I put up my blog back in 2007, tagal na, no? That's when people started asking me for financial advice. So sabi ko, I might as well transform my blog from an entrepreneurship blog towards becoming a personal finance and investment blog. And of course, to give myself some credibility, I underwent yung certification ng Registered Financial Planners Institute. So that, alam mo yun, para naman meron tayong maibibigay na credential sa mga humihingi ng financial advice. Hindi lang tayo basta-basta from experience kumukuha ng advice. But we actually underwent training and certification. Alright? So, yun ang ating life story. And maraming salamat. And actually, the reason why I said that is because it's somehow related sa topic natin ngayon. So, what do you do on weekends? What do you on weekends? So, kung mali pa talaga yung ating i-edit lang natin tayo. What do you do on weekends? Ayan. Na-correct na ba? Oh, di ba? So, instant ng ating correction. Ayan. Okay. So, what do you do on weekends? Bakit? Kasi yung kinuwento ko sa inyong buhay ko, a lot of the preparation nung transition from being an employee to being an entrepreneur, and of course, yung transition from being an employee to a freelancer and freelancer to an entrepreneur, lahat ng preparation and yung mga major tasks ko, I did it during weekends, no? So anyway, yun nga, no, sinasabi ko na a lot of the planning that I did happened on weekends. And para sa akin, very important ang weekends because it's really the time where you can pursue your hobbies and your passion. That is, of course, different from your work. Kasi siyempre, di ba, Monday to Friday, nagtatrabaho tayo from Monday to Friday, nagtatrabaho tayo sa opisina or sa kung ano man yung work natin. And I know a lot of people pagdating ng weekends, dalawa lang yung ginagawa. No? Either nagpapahinga or they continue to work. No? May work pa na sila pag weekends. Well, nothing wrong with doing that. But in my case, para sa akin, I've always looked at weekends as an opportunity to do something that can change your life. Laks ang heavy, no? Change your life. What do I mean? Of course, nothing wrong with just taking a rest during the weekend, no? Go ahead, catch up on your sleep, catch up on your favorite TV series, and spend time with your loved ones, etc. Go ahead, okay lang yun. Pero para sa akin, at least once a month, or ako, in my case, every other weekend, I try to do something that will help me get me closer to my goals, my personal goals. What do I mean? So, if ever, kunwari, ikaw ay empleyado and you want to resign from your job and put up your own business, then use the weekends as time for you to probably do a business plan, do some market research, etc. Ako, I also use my weekends to read, no? It's actually a great time to read. Take your screens, take your eyes off your gadgets and screens, no? But syempre, pag mayroon tayong live stream, sa atin tayo, sa akin kayo nanonood, no? But for me, especially Sunday night, no? It's also a time for me to do some planning for the week. So it's also something that I do, and I know from experience na it's very helpful. So para sa akin, during Sundays, I use that day to plan for my week. So iniisip ko na ano ba yung mga gagawin ko this week, what are the tasks that I need to accomplish. And of course, usually, alam niyo yung time na, I think it's already a habit of mine. Well, it is already a habit of mine na a few hours before I sleep, I try to give myself a checklist na ano bang gagawin ko bukas. Alam niyo, so ano ba yung mga must accomplish ko tomorrow. And every Sunday, usually after dinner, yan, yun naman yung time ko to plan na ano yung kailangan kong i-accomplish this week, no? Yun. And usually, yung last weekend of the month, yun naman yung aking time that I use to evaluate and plan for ano ba yung mga kailangan kong gawin next month. So, you're seeing a pattern here, no? So, yun. Tas, alam niyo yung week, no, between Christmas and New Year, usually, I use that time for me to set goals for the next year. So, basically, ganun yung isa sa mga goal-setting habits ko. So, of course, yun nga, ang weekend sa akin, I always use it to plan for the coming week ahead. And favorite ko dyan is yung after Sunday dinner. Ayan. So, yun. Ano pa bang ginagawa ko pag weekend? I read, of course, if there are events, maraming mga seminars, no? Na usually Saturday nangyayari. Yan. You can go ahead and attend that. Expand your knowledge. You expand your learning. Especially kung plano mo magnegosyo, I know for a fact that a lot of business seminars happen on Saturdays, no? Yung TESDA mismo, no, may mga skills training sila pag weekend because they are really meant for those who are working during the weekday. So pag weekend, you can attend yung mga training skills and skills development seminars saka mga business seminars ng TESDA and other institutions. And of course, you use this learning to create your business plan, to develop yung plano mong business so that, alam mo yun, pag nakaipon ka na nung kailangan mong kapital, you can eventually put up your business, grow it, and then eventually leave the corporate world, no? Kung yun ang goal mo. Of course, if your plan is really climb up the corporate ladder of your professional career, then of course you can use the weekend to improve your skills, no, or do some self-improvement na mga activities. And that's why I know some people who undergo mga management trainings. They also join yung mga social, civic, and professional organizations kasi that's how they improve their networking skills, social skills, negotiating skills nga. Minsan, doon din nila natututunan kasi they join organizations, they join clubs, no? Yeah, clubs talaga parang high school lang, no? But I know some people who spend time with ano ba yung mga Rotary, Toastmasters, and all of those, yung mga professional organizations. Because not only do you increase your network, but also you learn yung soft skills of networking. And a lot of these organizations, they also offer mga seminars na mga professional seminars that will help you improve your soft skills in the corporate world, yan, yung mga management skills, etc. Okay, so, kumusta kayo? So, basically, para sa akin, huwag nyo sayangin yung weekends nyo. Okay? So, what do you do on weekends? If it's the same thing every weekend, then probably it will do you good to spice it up a little. Yan. So, for example, during the first weekend, you pursue a hobby, diba? Sometimes what you do is to try to improve on yourself. You enroll on a skill or a skill class, a seminar or a course, no? A weekend course. Of course, you can also do some planning. You can develop your business plan, or if you're trying to build up a new source of income, then you can do some planning. And of course, you can also spend some time with your loved ones and rest. So sa akin, it's really for my experience, it did me a lot of good to do things differently, do different things during the weekend, as long as I feel that I am productive. Kasi may mga kilala talaga ako, party during the weekend. Nothing wrong with doing that, but if you keep on doing that every weekend, I think you're missing out on some great opportunities to expand yourself, no? Yun. So, I guess that's it for our topic for today. So, ask yourself, what do you do on weekends? And I hope you find things that will help you become a better version of you. Alright?